The Panthers back out on offense. Their running back headed out once again. And headed out with him, this promising rookie out of Miami.
Preseason football, you don't see the stars and starters quite as much, certainly in this day and age. But this is the land of opportunity for rookies coming in. Even coming in as a second-round pick, you know he's a key piece of their roster. And what a good chance to get acclimated to their system in a game setting and make some noise to earn an even bigger role right here ahead of him in week number one.
And the play clock expires. This is going to cost them half the distance.
Delay of game, offense.
Can't get the playoff in time, and I'm going to wager the call is going to come in much quicker, Brock, for this next snap.
Let's go now.
Hand down to the back. And they'll bring him down after a pretty short game. They made it 3 yards on the tote. It'll bring up second down.
Here we go, here we go. Check, pick, cut.
Back-to-back carries here. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. A gain of about 3, so a third of what they needed. 3rd and 6 coming up.
This close to your own goal line, they really don't want to risk a sack. That means, well, one option, run it and buy whatever breathing room you can.
And he's short of the first after a mild gain. They give him 5 on the play. That leaves him facing 4th down.
That run's not going to turn many heads, but at the end of the year, I promise you, if you average over 5 yards a run, you can be a Pro Bowler.
Panthers and their running back about to get back to work. And within that group, a rookie taken in the 2nd round of this past NFL draft.
Here we go.
Play action on 1st down. It's caught. That's Thielen. And that tackle stops him after a solid game.
That's a pretty similar result to a 1st down run play. Moves it forward, keeps you on schedule, and makes 2nd and 3rd down a whole lot easier to manage.
The give here on 2nd. Has a lane past the 45. And they'll finally get him at the 47-yard line.
Okay, ready?
We've arrived at the end of one on Thursday night. Neither side separating much so far. More from Gillette Stadium in just a minute. Too long, Brock. We'd be headed for overtime, but as we all know here in the preseason, we're gonna leave with a tie. A couple of teams and expanded rosters giving it their all in an entertaining contest ahead of our regular season.
Hey, RC, you remember them backs you played? They coming downhill between the tackles. You got to hit them. First quarter, you might get them down. By the fourth quarter, that shoulder done got real sore on you. This young guy has that. He going to get you three guaranteed every time.
There was a great philosopher from Atlanta who once said, we some head busters. That's exactly what this
What's up, rookie? Welcome to the league. And I truly believe that you're going to be a star. But in order to make it and last in this league, it's going to take hard work. And the grind don't stop, baby. Because right now, the cheetah grinding, baby.
Panthers offense and their running back getting set for this next possession. They'll search for the first points of this game as they begin the drive on first and 10.
Let's go!
Here's the rookie running back out of Miami. Good run there. Going to get him 5 yards.
Trent Williams on the stop. It's a gain of 5.
Ready.
Second and 5. At the 25-yard line.
Green. Switch. Yellow. Yellow. Lonnie. Check white. Hut, hut.
Back to the ground. He'll get it again. And he'll get maybe a yard. That's it. That's Jermaine Johnson Set, there on
ready.
The stop. Here's a third down and 4.
Ready?
They'll try to get this one on the ground.
He's tackled at the 29-yard line. A 2-yard gain. It's fourth down.
Panthers now ready to get to work on offense for the first time. We'll see how they want to attack things here, backed up deep in their own end. It's first and 10.
Come on, set, ready, ready.
They'll begin here on the ground, and that'll be a pickup of 3. Second and 7.
And 7 at the 12-yard line.
Ready.
They'll stick with him again. And he'll only manage to pick up 3 yards. And that leads to third down.
Here we go, set. Set, cut.
On play action, Young. And this is going to be incomplete. That's great work to get in there and make things difficult defensively, setting up a fourth down.
And that's exactly how you teach it. They want these defenders to time the hit, that right when the ball gets there, you separate the receiver from the ball. And those are the ones on offense, man. You just have to.
The Panthers now ready to get to work on offense for the first time. They'll be hoping to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 our score as this drive begins with a first down.
Down.
His drive will start on the ground, and he is crushed in the backfield. Defenders firing through. Shut it down right away for a loss of yardage. They'll turn and hand this one off. Now the Jets going to use the first of their timeouts. We'll talk things over before third down.
Let's go now.
Off the play fake. Oh, they are on him with a flash, and he's lost the football. The Panthers now ready to get to work on offense for the first time. They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit, 14-0, the score, as the offense tries to regroup and get going with first and 10.
Here we go, here we go.
Up the middle they go. Not much there, maybe a yard.
Ready, break.
Brings up second and 9 at the 31-yard line.
A handoff as they try to run it here. And he'll manage to get to the 33. Tony Adams there on the stop.
Here we go.
Third and 7.
He'll go play action. And this drive is over before it can start. He's swallowed up to force fourth down. The Panthers now ready to get to work on offense for the first time, and they start in the best possible situation. It is first and goal.
Set.
Here's a run to the 5-yard line. The Panthers will take their first timeout. Clock is stopped for 26 seconds until the break.
Let's go.
They'll go with him again. He'll get a couple, mark him down at the 3.
Ready up.
Good job so far by the defense.
Ready.
Protecting the short field. Now
ready.
It's third and goal. No place to run there. Good job by the D to stop him at the 2.
A gain of a yard.
This one, a win for the visiting Jets. As we move closer to the regular season, they'll wrap up the preseason with the finale next week before we get it.
down some chips. We go 0 to 100 real quick. Maybe on that rap to pay the bills. Now I'm better, not even a little bit. Oh Lord, know yourself, know your worth.
Panthers and this running back headed back out for a new series. First carry here for the rookie from the U. And he found some running room for a nice gain. Give him 9 yards. He almost moved the chains there. It's going to be second and one. Another carry for him. And he's down after getting this up to the 41. A gain of a lone yard for Brock. That's all they needed. First down.
On the set. Here we go, set, ready.
They give it to him again. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
This is one of those situations, Kate, where I watch the body language of the running back, because it'd be very easy for him to raise his hands up, look to the sideline in his O-line and go, what am I supposed to do there? There was nothing, no time at all to try and escape and react. Instead, it goes backwards. You know you love some of my buzzwords, kid. I know you do. And this one was about real power. He got to rock a long way from the chains and put his teammates on his back for a heck of a run and a great try at that first down.
Here's the give on third and short. And he'll get them enough for a first down. They won't snap it in time. That is going to be the end of the first quarter. Neither side separating much so far. We'll return to Highmark Stadium in just a moment. Second quarter, it's Panthers football.
Here we go.
They're looking at yet another first and 10 on this drive. Here's the one back on the handoff. And that's only 1 yard up the middle. Gonna be second down.
I think one thing you learn, Kate, when you transition from college to the NFL, not every run is gonna be a big play. Some of them, well, they're just destined to end in a minimal gain, and some of them will set up that critical play action for later.
And the fumble recovery is made. It's a 13-yard play, and that's enough for the first. Almost the impact play this defense was searching for, but they could only get half the job done, partner. Fumble forced, but they couldn't recover.
I'll tell you what else it forces, though. That coordinator, that play caller on the other side, now got a little bit of doubt about his ball handlers. Got to have better ball security than that.
And he'll only find 1 yard up the gut. Second down.
The only thing I could say positive about the execution of that play, at least he didn't go backwards.
He's ready.
Back to the well again. And he's brought down for a loss.
I know from the position of the quarterback, Kate, sometimes you hand that ball, you put it in the belly of the running back, and you send him right into the teeth of a buzzsaw. You can feel it from the jump, and that call from the defense, well, it came at the perfect time.
He'll make a bid for it on the ground. And they're going to bring him down just as we've come up to the 2-minute warning. Offense set for a first and 10.
Blue check. Ready. Set.
Now we're on the counter. And he drives into a pile of defenders and is stopped right at the line. Second and 10. Need to get some positive yardage here. Back-to-back carries here. And they corral him after a minimal gain to the 21. Only a couple yards there, and now it's third and the handoff, now to throw. Got a man, it's Thomas. And he's going to be stopped at the 17-yard line. The Bills are going to go ahead and call their first timeout as they'll get together and discuss with fourth down coming up. Visitors returning their offense and this running back to the field. They'll try to get that ground game established better than they did in the opening half, Bronx. See if they can attack that deficit.
Here we go, set. Opposite, three. Cut, cut.
They'll run here on first down. And he's going to get up to about the 33, but no more. Second down now, seven to go. Blown back in the backfield, and they give it to him. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. Third and six for them to figure out now. Off the play fake, he's going to throw. Complete beyond the marker. And they'll make the stop up at the 46-yard line.
Okay, right?
They'll come up first and ten.
Let's go now. Ready.
Blown back in the backfield, and he gets the handoff. And the defense gets there to force a small loss.
They say about great outfielders in baseball, there's just something to them. They've got a knack of feel and instinct to take the right line, the right angle. For safeties to create tackles for loss in the run game, it's the exact same attribute and skill set. Got to take that right angle and then go finish that runner. I call this quarterback's best friend. Some call it a safety valve, some call it automatic, but it's sure nice as a quarterback when you got a trusty running back over the middle of the field that you can depend on.
And their struggles on the ground continue as he's tackled after a small gain. Give him 2 yards on the run. That leaves him one short, and it brings up fourth down. This offense running out for a new series, led by their running back. And the running lanes, and they've been hazardous. Not quite the decorated collection of highlights from him that we're going to look at here. Those big plays, the explosive runs where he leads an offense, just haven't been there for him in this one.
Set, hunt.
On first down, they'll run. And he's tackled after gaining a handful. Give him five on that carry. Bring it up second and five.
Here we go.
Blown back, gets the handoff. And he's brought down after a solid gain on what's going to be the final play of the quarter. Well, the defense is really buckled down. That was a scoreless third quarter for us. The Panthers have it to start, coming in trailing on the scoreboard. So the Panthers pick up the win here. And this victory is going to give them a nice shot of confidence as they work through the next couple of weeks and prepare for things to count coming up in week one. This offense headed out as we get a look at their running back. And headed out with him, this promising rookie running back.
This right here, Kate, has got to be one of the best moments of his life as he takes the field for the first time in a regular season game as a pro. It's a lifetime of work to get to this point and a well-earned chance to go make your debut. And it'll be a career's worth of work moving forward to make teams regret not taking him in the first round of the NFL draft.
Give now to the running back. And they've got him behind the line for a big loss. Offense at the line, but they won't snap it. We've got a timeout. The give here on second. And he found some running room for a nice gain. And 7 yards on the run. Still 6 to go on third.
I'm not kidding you, Kate. A run of that length at the NFL level, honestly, is the equivalent of a run of 15-plus at the high school level. It's hard in the run game to make yards.
And the Saints came marching home, and they dropped him. And the defense comes through to back him up ahead of fourth down. Push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs.
Now, don't think for a second they're going to slow down the tempo. Defense on their heels. And right now is the best chance to push that envelope and get aggressive.
Just one play into this drive, and they're already sitting on their own 45. Going to the ground again on first. And he drives this across midfield and down into enemy territory. Well, not what you like to see. Still just in the opening quarter of the season. And they have an injured player out there. Let's hope it's nothing major as he gets looked at. From just shy of midfield on second down. Got a man open. Complete. Big gain. 14 on the play. And that'll be good for a Carolina first. They're set up at the 35 now. Right up the gut. And he has it down officially to the red zone at the 20. We're through one quarter of this opening weekend of football. 7-0 is our score. Back to the Superdome of Caesar in just a bit. Time for our second quarter here, and the Panthers are thinking points. First down, and they go right back to it. And all he can get is 1 yard, ran that right into the defensive front.
Well, they got some positive yards. That's a good thing. But too many plays like that, it just is too hard to pile together, get first downs. It gets the better defenses in this league.
Second down. Nice cut back to the right sideline. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs.
You know, Kate, if you notice those guys that love to feed themselves on the field, right? They love to just get more and more. They're hungry for even more. I'll tell you what, that tackle, it prevented something that's going to be a lot bigger. But that back remains hungry.
They'll try and punch it in. He's able to power this forward, but they stop him after 2 yards. It's second and goal. They'll send him up the middle. And they take it across the goal line for a Carolina touchdown. The Panthers can tie it up in the second after cutting into the lead. he found some running room for a nice gain. Good rip on first down. That brings up second and two.
So much to like about that run, particularly what he was able to get out of it. The defense, I think, feels a little fortunate they were able to track him down before an even bigger run and crossing that first down marker.
That short gain is enough for a new set of downs.
Hey, Kate, you want to see a picture in the football dictionary of staying on schedule? That was it.
We slated downs to approach here from the 40. They go play action on first. Big catch is made, and he got the feed in, too. They get 18 yards out of it and a new set of downs.
Kid, I can't tell you how good that is. Anticipating the outcut, having the ball on the way before the receiver's head even turns, he puts it on him so that receiver can easily get out of bounds for the nice game.
And he works this to the 15 before they make the stop. Now we get a timeout by the Panthers. It's their first. They are now set for first and 10. Here's the handoff. And they're going to bring him down after he drives it down to the 7. Timeout taken by the offense, their second. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and 1. They give it to him again. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains. Now the Panthers decide to spend their third and final timeout. And that's all they've got for what little remains of this half. He hands it off. And he's going to get this up to the 45 before he's brought down. After that play, we see some concern from their guys on the field. And now we know why. One of their best players was hurt on the play and is getting worked on. Just one play into this drive, and they're already sitting on their own 45. Carry for him, and he's gonna get stopped right around the 45-yard line. They're signaling for a stoppage here, and yep, there's a player injured after that snap. Not what they wanted to see in week one, as their medical staff heads out to check on it. Options are open here. It's second and inches. Down.
That's certainly a spot where you could be more aggressive, kid, if you wanted to take your shots. And some coaches, even the bolder ones, to take the safe play first when they get it from time to time. No third down required now.
Ball at the 33 for first down. Young to throw it. Into traffic, complete. and he's brought down after a short gain. Whistles after that play for an unfortunate sight. A player hurt in the first game of the season. Training staff out to work on it. Going ground here. He finds space into the red zone. And he's finally taken down at the 16-yard line. That play gains 15, and it moves the sticks. They have themselves another first and 10. Working inside the red zone. He completes it in traffic. And he's able to get this down to the 13. Second down now, 7 to go. Here's the give. And he's going to score. Touchdown, Carolina. The Panthers take the lead right away in half number two. Well, Rocky found himself some space to work, and from there, wow, all athleticism as he made his way into the end zone.
You got that right, Kate. Just that speed. You got to have some different gear when you get down here to the red zone. It's hard to score rushing touchdowns. And that running back sees the open space, he sees the green grass, and he finishes it off with 6.
Straight ahead, but the front stops him after a gain of 3.
That's the kind of run play that feels like tug-of-war in field day. And you're just not moving the other side. Just a short run. Neither side feels particularly good about it, and we'll move to the next.
Back-to-back carries here. And he'll take it up to the 30 before being brought down. They're signaling for a stoppage here, and yep, there's a player injured after that snap. Not what they wanted to see in week one as their medical staff heads out to check on it. First and 10 now from the 30. They go play action here. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. That play goes for 19 and a new set of downs. First and 10 from a yard shy of midfield. They hand this one off. And he's able to reach the 40 on that play. It's a pickup of 11. And it'll give the Panthers a first down.
You spring a big game like that, Kate, on the interior. 9 times out of 10, that O-line decisively won their matchup with the big fellas up front. They got those pads down. They created leverage, and they opened up that running lane.
On first down, they'll run. And with a nice gain, he runs him down inside of field goal range. Call it 9 yards. Looks like a first for a moment. It's second and 1. We've reached the end of 3 in our week 1 opener. It's the Panthers in possession of it, needing to preserve that lead over one final quarter. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and 1.
Let's go.
Here's the long back on the handoff. And he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away.
An offensive group really hoped he was going to get it all right there, reset it back to first down. But instead, defense, they're not going to let anything come easy. And their fight is giving them a chance to stall things out on a third and short.
The handoff shorts. And his short game gets them a new set of downs.
That is your old school meat and potatoes call right there. Don't even think about throwing it. Just rush it ahead, get what you need.
The drive picks up here, first and 10. Here's a give up the middle. And they try to power it forward, but only a couple of yards there. 8 yards to go. Let's see how they approach this second down. Now he'll throw off the play fake. Got it. And he'll go down shy of the end zone. They mark him at the 4. And even 20 yards on the play, and it awards them with a first and goal.
This entire play, Kate, depends on how well he could separate from his man. You get man-to-man coverage of really about two things, separation and trust. Because QBs want to throw it before he breaks, that's the trust, and then they got to believe that that separation can create the big play down the field.
Four downs now to get in. Here's first and goal. Right up the gut. And the defense is all over this one for a big loss. Second chance at 6 here. It's second and goal. Oh, look at this. He's setting up to throw. It's caught. And he's going to score. Touchdown, Carolina. The Panthers parlay the interception into points. Well, in a close game, they needed somebody to make that type of play. Now it pushes their lead to a couple of scores and makes a comeback that much more difficult.
You know, Kate, their offense did its part and padded the lead. Now it's up to this defense to make this 2-score lead hold up and carry it across the finish line.
Give now to the running back. And he made the most of his running room on that one, getting it down to the 27. We have a timeout here. Second one taken by New Orleans. Second and 3 now.
Here we go. Here we go.
Hand off to the back. And he's going to be stopped at the 17-yard line. The Saints call their third and final timeout. And they are quite frustrated having to call that after giving up the first.
Ready.
Still on the move, coming to the line for first and 10. Trying the handoff. And the power play up the gut only results in 2 yards.
You know, not a ton of yards, but still showing that commitment to the ground game. The type of run that keeps the defense from loading up in coverage and focusing entirely on that passing game.
Wow, they're going to pass it here. He brings it in. And he'll get this inside the 10 to the 9. All plays on the table here for 3rd and 3. Try and pick this up on the ground. And he's going to score. Touchdown, Carolina. The Panthers stretch their lead to a 3-score advantage. So an exclamation point there. That caps off what, and I think you'd agree, Brock, has been a dominating performance.
Yeah, I would. Really in all phases, too. You know, I thought coming in that this would be a much closer game than how it's turned out to be. And you got to give credit where it's due. This offense has been outstanding throughout.
Mm-hmm.